everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today's how-to is brought to you by, I have no idea. Sorry, I forgot who asked about this, but doing a double peg tutorial today. Got my friend Evan over here, you know, hanging out and stuff. Yeah, we're gonna do the how-to double peg for those that don't know how to double peg. I'm trying to make this a little bit contextual to anyone that is trying to figure this out by going on this really high ledge for me, because that way I can kind of understand the struggle. Me struggling onto this, it's probably the equivalent of you struggling onto like a ledge like around this height. So I just thought it makes sense to do it on a pretty high ledge. The Evan grind here real quick, the 360. Yeah. Without further ado, this is the double peg how to. So first, you should know how to bunny hop. I mean, that's pretty obvious. As far as the approach of the ledge, I personally like to approach the ledge a little bit of an angle, not exactly parallel to it, because that means you kind of have to like transfer over. I like to go at an angle. It's just a little bit less thinking, a little bit less having to worry about having to shift and missing your back peg, because you kind of just run into the ledge. So go at it at an angle, around like 2 miles an hour. Go at a pretty slow speed at first, especially if the ledge doesn't slide that well. I don't want you to go fast as hell and then just flip because the ledge's weight doesn't slide at all. Go like a good speed, like maybe like a 2 miles an hour type of speed. So maybe like this speed is good right here, like around there. I personally like to land front peg first. It kind of serves as a guide because you could always land front peg and then possibly catch your pedal on the way down in case you do miss your back and just at least not get killed completely and save yourself. If you aim for the back peg first and you completely miss, you're kind of fucked, you know? So I personally like to land front peg first and then the back peg kind of follows through with the front. I will show you that right now. So yeah, I personally like to land front peg first. Like I said, it's a little bit of a safety net in my opinion, where you just kind of securely get on better. Same thing with the Smith video that I did. I just like to land front peg first. It kind of hurts a little on your wrist, but it's definitely the safer play in my opinion. So the next step, once you actually get onto the ledge, is balance. I'm not the best at double peg balancing, I'm okay. But in my opinion, leaning a little bit more forward or like lower, kind of like lowering your center of gravity, is that the right word? Center of weight, I don't know, whatever the right terminology is. Just lowering your weight a little bit kind of helps with balancing a little bit easier, kind of like keeps you from going side to side so much. I try to just lower my center of gravity a little, but a ledge versus a rail is a little bit different, where on a ledge, you don't really fall over left to right as badly as like a rail because you have to balance more. And that's where you kind of use your knees and you see people going like this and stuff on a rail, because they're just using their weight to kind of counter the tipping effect the other way. Yeah, as far as that, I think you just got to practice. Practice is definitely the most important thing to learn your balance better. So once you do that, how do you get off the damn thing, right? Getting off double peg, there's two ways you can do it. It depends really on how you're good at bunny hopping. Some people like to actually like bunny hop like front end first, then back end. I personally do a little bit in between, where like I do sometimes a double bunny hop off to get myself off. That sounded weird. So there's two ways you can get off the ledge. One is just pull your front end up and then get the back end off like that. Or you can do a double bunny hop thing if your weight distribution feels kind of funny, where you don't have that pull. I just kind of do the double bunny hop off, and I'm sure you know how to do a double bunny hop. So you just go like this, and I could get off that way too. But once you learn the balance and how to get on, it's way easier to actually get off, because you could just pull the front end up if you're coming off the end of something like a ledge or a rail. The best thing to do is just practice on something small, a low rail or a low ledge, and make sure it slides. Once you like kind of figure out the peg stalls, you'll be better at it. The reason you really want to learn a double peg is because you want to do a rail, right? So let's take this over to the fake rail over here and do some rail learning. You can find yourself a handrail about this high, stem height. I think that's a good low rail. Just like before I said, I'd approach it more of a little bit of an angle versus going right parallel at it. That way you can just kind of like run into it. For rails though, the biggest issue is if you do the running into method, you might start leaning in too much and then fall over. So you kind of have to counter that by kind of leaning out against the direction you're going, and that'll help you balance on the rail better. Same exact theory of landing front peg first, letting your back peg kind of follow using momentum. Try your best to jump out. You're not landing up here, you're landing like further over here, and which is way lower because the incline makes it go down, your height drops, all that physics science stuff, you know? I'm going to approach this a little bit of an angle. Front peg first, in my opinion. Speed-wise, I like to go a little bit quicker than like how I just showed you on that ledge. The more further down you land, the lower it is. And also you need speed to like get off the end, because otherwise you're gonna get stuck on this. And the faster you go, the easier it is to balance. Think about like standing on your bike still, balancing. It's way harder than while you're moving, because it's just the momentum kind of helps you balance better. So going a little bit quicker will help you balance on the rail better. And then once you get towards the end, just pull up the front end as hard as you can. That way your front end doesn't drop first, and you should be good to go. So let's give this a try right now. Cool. If you're gonna try this, start on a skate park rail or something. Don't go in the street and get killed like we used to do. Evan's right there staring at me. Yeah, we learned the hard way. We didn't have skate parks when we were growing up, so I didn't do a handrail for a long time because I was too scared. Too scared of stairs, too scared of missing. You're very fortunate you have skate parks around where you could actually practice this stuff. I would definitely practice on a skate park. If you don't have a skate park, then you are gonna have to do it on a real rail. Try to find the smallest rail in town. That's what we did. But definitely practice your bunny hops and your getting on like high ledges first. I think that's a good way that I built confidence for myself, at least. I was trying to just double peg really high things, not really high, but like higher things, feeling more confident, just like getting on easily. And that helped me get on real rails because I just knew I wasn't gonna miss. But you have to also be careful if you're trying to double peg a rail, don't go way too high and then go over the rail by mistake either. So definitely have to learn the control of your height and everything when you're doing real rails. So I hope that helped. And you know what to do if you got questions. Leave them in the comments. I always answer back, and I'm gonna try to answer everything. I know sometimes I miss some details, so I'm just kind of think on the fly over here. So sometimes I miss details, but I will answer as best as I can. Also, let me know what other how-tos you want to learn, because I'm running out of ideas here. Anyway, see you next time. Bye-bye.